FAA's and Elon Musk's major reaction to Ship 34 anomaly. What did they say? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. The eighth test flight of SpaceX's Starship program, featuring Ship 34 and Booster 15, took place on March 6, 2025, marking another crucial step in the development of the world's largest and most powerful rocket system. This mission aimed to push the boundaries of the Starship system, incorporating several design improvements and experimental objectives. However, the flight ended with an anomaly that caused the upper stage to spin uncontrollably and ultimately break apart over the Gulf of America. The incident has sparked intense discussion within the aerospace community and raised questions about the path forward for SpaceX's ambitious Starship program. Ship 34, the latest iteration of the Starship upper stage, incorporated numerous improvements based on lessons learned from previous test flights. Engineers at SpaceX had focused on enhancing the vehicle's structural integrity, refining its thermal protection system, and optimizing its propulsion capabilities. The Raptor engines, the heart of Starship's propulsion system, underwent several modifications to improve their performance and reliability. These changes included redesigned turbopumps, enhanced cooling systems, and upgraded ignition sequences. The vehicle's avionics and flight control systems also received updates, with more robust software and hardware implementations to better handle the extreme conditions of spaceflight. In the weeks leading up to the launch, SpaceX conducted an extensive series of ground tests to validate the improvements made to Ship 34. These tests included cryogenic proof tests, where the vehicle was filled with supercooled propellants to simulate flight conditions, as well as static fire tests of the Raptor engines. The company also performed numerous simulations and hardware-in-the-loop tests to verify the performance of the updated flight control systems. Despite the rigorous testing regime, spaceflight remains an inherently risky endeavor, and unforeseen challenges can always arise during actual flight conditions. The launch attempt on March 6th was not the first for this particular mission. An initial launch attempt on March 4th was scrubbed due to a last-minute technical issue. During the final countdown, engineers detected an anomaly in one of the ground support equipment systems responsible for fueling the vehicle. Out of an abundance of caution, the launch was postponed to allow time for a thorough investigation and resolution of the issue. This decision underscored SpaceX's commitment to safety and their willingness to delay a high-profile test rather than proceed with any unresolved concerns. When the launch finally took place on March 6th, initial flight phases proceeded nominally. The massive first stage, Booster 15, performed flawlessly, separating from Ship 34 at the planned altitude and executing a controlled descent back to the launch site. The upper stage continued its ascent, igniting its engines for the climb to orbit. It was during this phase of flight that the first signs of trouble became apparent. Observers noted that the vehicle began to deviate from its expected trajectory, exhibiting unusual oscillations that grew in amplitude over time. As Ship 34 continued its flight, the situation rapidly deteriorated. The vehicle entered an uncontrolled spin, with its rotation rate increasing dramatically. This spin posed a severe challenge to the flight control systems, which struggled to maintain stability and control. Despite the best efforts of the onboard computers and the ground control team, the spin could not be arrested, and the structural integrity of the vehicle was soon compromised. Recent speculation surrounding the failure of Starship Ship 34 during its test flight has focused on a potential issue with one of its Raptor vacuum, RVAC, engines. While not officially confirmed by SpaceX, viral posts on social media platform X suggest that telemetry data and visual observations indicate a possible catastrophic failure of an RVAC engine during the flight. This alleged engine failure may have occurred due to extreme forces and conditions caused by an uncontrolled spin of the vehicle, which could have further destabilized Ship 34 and possibly led to a cascade of issues that ultimately resulted in the vehicle's breakup over the Gulf of America. The exact cause of Ship 34's failure is still under investigation by SpaceX and relevant authorities. Several theories have emerged, including a malfunction in the vehicle's attitude control system, unexpected aerodynamic interactions during ascent, structural failures, or propellant management issues that could have shifted the vehicle's center of mass and induced the spin. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. You know, we are on a mission to reach 70,000 subscribers by next week. Join us on this journey, and let's see if we can make it happen together. SpaceX has not yet released an official statement regarding the specific cause of the anomaly. As with previous test flights, the company is likely conducting a thorough analysis of all available data to determine the root cause and implement necessary improvements for future launches. As of now, we will wait for the official findings from SpaceX, which will be crucial for understanding the incident and advancing the development of the Starship program. The uncontrolled spin of Ship 34 not only led to its destruction, but also posed potential safety risks as debris scattered over a wide area of the Gulf of America. SpaceX worked closely with relevant authorities to track the debris field and ensure that any potential hazards were promptly addressed, highlighting the importance of robust safety measures and contingency planning for such experimental flights. Now, coming on to Elon's reaction. Elon Musk, CEO of SpaceX, broke his usual pattern of immediate reactions to Starship flights by responding to the Flight 8 anomaly nearly 4 hours after the incident. In a series of replies on X, formerly Twitter, Musk acknowledged the upper stage failure and emphasized the learning experience gained from building the new ship design and conducting the flight. He admitted, "It was an upper stage ship failure, to be honest," while highlighting the valuable insights acquired. Musk also reflected on the broader challenge of space exploration, stating, "Not easy making life multiplanetary." Despite the setback, he maintained an optimistic outlook, characterizing the day's events as a minor setback and asserting that progress is measured over time. Musk concluded by announcing that the next Starship would be ready for flight in 4 to 6 weeks, demonstrating SpaceX's commitment to rapid iteration and improvement in their pursuit of advanced spaceflight capabilities. In the aftermath of the Ship 34 anomaly, attention has turned to the potential actions of the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, which oversees commercial space launches in the United States. The FAA plays a crucial role in ensuring the safety of commercial space activities and protecting public interests. Following such a significant anomaly, it is standard procedure for the FAA to conduct a thorough review of the incident and SpaceX's response. The FAA's investigation will likely focus on several key areas. First, they will examine the pre-flight testing and preparation procedures to ensure that all necessary safety precautions were taken. This will include a review of the technical issue that led to the initial launch scrub and how it was resolved. The agency will also scrutinize the flight data and telemetry to understand the sequence of events that led to the anomaly and assess whether any regulatory requirements were violated during the flight. Furthermore, the FAA will evaluate SpaceX's incident response and investigation process. This includes how quickly and effectively the company implemented its emergency procedures, communicated with relevant authorities, and initiated its own internal investigation. The thoroughness and transparency of SpaceX's investigation will be critical factors in the FAA's assessment. Based on its findings, the FAA may take a range of actions. In the most severe case, the agency could suspend SpaceX's launch license for the Starship program until certain conditions are met or safety concerns are addressed. However, given SpaceX's track record and the experimental nature of the Starship program, a more likely outcome might be the imposition of additional oversight measures or specific technical requirements for future launches. The FAA's response will need to balance the need for safety with the importance of fostering innovation in the commercial space industry. The Starship program represents a significant leap forward in space technology, with potential applications ranging from deep space exploration to revolutionizing satellite deployment and even point-to-point transportation on Earth. Recognizing the value of such ambitious projects, the FAA may work collaboratively with SpaceX to address any identified issues while allowing the development program to continue under enhanced scrutiny. For SpaceX, the loss of Ship 34 represents a setback, but not an insurmountable one. The company has a history of learning from failures and rapidly iterating its designs. The data gathered from this flight, including the events leading up to and during the anomaly, will prove invaluable for improving future versions of Starship. SpaceX's engineering teams will likely conduct a comprehensive root cause analysis, examining every aspect of Ship 34's design, manufacturing, and operation to identify potential weaknesses or areas for improvement. One of the key challenges moving forward will be addressing the issue of vehicle stability during all phases of flight. This may involve refining the aerodynamic design of Starship, enhancing the capabilities of its flight control systems, or developing new strategies for managing unexpected disturbances during ascent. The RVAC engine failure will also likely lead to a re-evaluation of the engine design and its integration with the vehicle structure, potentially resulting in modifications to improve its resilience under extreme conditions. Despite the setback, SpaceX remains committed to the Starship program and its long-term goals. The company has always emphasized that these test flights are part of a learning process and that setbacks are an expected part of pushing the boundaries of space technology. In the coming weeks and months, SpaceX will likely provide updates on its investigation findings and plans for future test flights. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.